But then, she and Owen spun around as they heard a scraping, swishing noise coming from near the window. Professor Bright was crawling out from under the bed. The professor was covered in dust. A slim, bony man, his curly, graying hair and beard were wild, and May saw a dust bunny caught in his beard and a spiderweb hooked on his right ear. His eyes were wide and panicked, but he looked unhurt and was now scrambling to his feet, seemingly ready to make a run for it. "Where have they gone? Did they leave?" he asked May and Owen breathlessly, staring from one to the other, and then, in a more coherent tone, "And who are you?" "We're police," May told him shortly. "We're here to question you regarding a series of crimes." At that moment, they heard the racing of a car engine down the road. The professor tensed, as if ready to dive back under the bed. Owen strode to the door, looking out. But then, the radio crackled. May ran out, heading to the car and grabbed it out, listening anxiously to the progress update. "We've arrived at the scene. We're approaching with firearms ready. We can see a vehicle with four suspects. They're attempting to extricate another partially submerged vehicle. Be careful. They are armed and dangerous." May held her breath, waiting for any updates. If needs be, she told herself, she'd jump in the car and drive down there herself to help out. But then, the update came again. "The suspects are surrounded. They're surrendering their weapons. We're taking them in. It looks like these weapons are illegal, and from a quick check, we've already established that at least one of these men is a felon who has violated parole conditions. We'll be keeping them in holding cells." May breathed a sigh of relief. She ran back to the trailer.